There we go, darling.
Thank you so much.
Pick it up, Vicky.
My wife's secretary and I'm treasurer. She's secretary, I'm vice chairman.
Say, if you want to join, are you in an engine by any chance? You've got a job for life. A job for life. Yeah, absolutely.
So these are made by, a lot of these were made by the Savage Arms from the Inverarity. The true story about this is the Captain Lou Strange.
Yes.
And he was actually in combat with the Germans on his own. And what happened was he's one of the first SE-5s where the Lewis gun was mounted on the top wing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. They had no firing for the machine guns.
No.
Well, he come down, it is stopped because he ran about ammunition. Pulls down the rack, presses the button to pull it off.
That's it, your point.
He's giving it a bit of blue air. He said, in accident, he knocked the gears, the joystick, the same time the piece of wind caught it. And he's now upside down, and he's hanging onto this Lewis truck.
Yes.
Don't come.
Yes.
Yeah, and the Germans are actually still flying alongside him, and the Germans killed himself laughing.
Yeah.
He managed to, after three attempts, to get one foot inside the cockpit by pulling himself up back and out. He kicked the joystick over, and as it turned over, just the right way, the drum came off, and he landed on the seat.
Yeah.
And the German looked at him, and he looked at the German. And they both waved at each other. The German flew over his lines and he flew back to his. And this is a true story.
Thank you.
was a forklifter. I don't know what these. Bus. Quad bike.
I thought that was red hat.
Yeah. Red shoes, red shoes.
Dear, oh dear.
I had a sudden and rapid promotion.
Yes, oh brilliant.
Right, we'll do a quick run round because that's where.
Well, you may be Mr. Bike. I was actually after them, but never mind. Let's have a chat about this one. How are you?
Oh, very well, thank you. Great to meet you again. We're coming from here, so it's great to get the bikes out and just have a ride round again.
Seen anything approach over here today?
No, not yet.
Well, there's plenty of time. It's only our first display. I'm going to keep the wallet closed. That's going to be a challenge for you, I'm telling you, because we have some fantastic stuff here. Thank you so much for bringing in. Absolutely brilliant display going on in the main arena. So if you do want to come down and have a look at our motorcycle display, not only have we got two-wheel vehicles in here, we've also got a quad which is going to be coming up with, and we've also got motorcycle and side cars in with us as well. So then, sir, what have we brought in with us today? This is a replica BMW i75, and we've got sidecar with us as well. What year are we looking at for these two? It's a replica, it's actually a Russian Ural. Ah, so behind the paintwork lies its true identity. Why have you changed it to a replica?
A lot cheaper. A lot cheaper. We've got it in Africa core colours, and we decided to add our own camouflage and the Normandy colours.
Great stuff. Now, what machine gun have we got on here then?
MG34.
And are those live rounds?
No.
Good.
Sorry.
No, a fantastic display that you've put on here. You've gone for a replica. I can see that there's a lot of attention to detail that you've done for this bike. How long has it taken you to get it to this state?
A couple of years, I think. Just adding bits and pieces as and when time and money allows, really.
Brilliant. Well, I'm going to let you carry on going around. Enjoy your time in the arena. You've got loads of time. You've got another 20 minutes in here, so enjoy it. Then we're going to catch up with one of our four-wheel friends. Hello there, how are you?
Hello.
How are things?
Alright, thanks.
What have we brought in here?
This is a Yamaha 250 quad, used by US Army. We bought them when we first started using them, we bought them as civilian models, and then now they're progressing to more custom models.
excellent stuff. How, do you know the history of this vehicle? Is this an ex-military vehicle or was it a civilian that you then converted?
This is a civilian one converted. Obviously, a lot of the military ones don't actually survive service. The military are using them for basically supplying fire points with ammunition and water, so it only takes one guy instead of a few. Put them on the foot patrols, pop a trailer to the back.
Thank you. This is the long one. This one, my short jacket's in the thing, and the waistcoat is in the thing.
I'd love to see it when you pass by and if you're wearing it. So even when you were hospitalised, just to look at
you? You didn't have to, but obviously...
You chose to.
Of course, isn't it? As my granddad still did the gardening. Shirt and collar.
And then scrubbed out with it.
You didn't have to get fully undressed. Because you're not there, you had two shirts and stuff, didn't you?
How much have you got on your glasses, Dean?
Thank you.
Hey,
Thank you, good to see you. I'll see you down there later.
We'll be doing a run every hour.
Yeah.
So.
They were no longer a frontline fighter. They used them in ground attack and tank busters and put 40 millimeter cannons on them and all sorts of tricks like that. So that's basically all there is to it. But obviously got armoured windscreen in front of you, which is laminated glass. That would take a 20 millimeter cannon hit. without braking. Mm-hmm. It totally knacker it. You're going to see through it anymore, but it would stop you having your head taken off.
Yes.
And you've got a bit of armour behind you in the sea, and that's about it.
It'll be 1 o'clock now, the next one.
1 o'clock?
1 o'clock, yeah. Oh,
thank you.
All right.
One little lad coming back at 20 past. That's if he gets here.
Can I sit in it when you start it up?
Unfortunately, they're all sold out. So. They've all sold out.
Is that what they do that? They
yeah,
can do that?
They've
wow.
Online.
Yeah. Yeah. And can you get at the controls to rev it up a bit?
Yeah, we rev it up for you sort of thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, there's like some good chocks in front of it.
Yeah.
Somebody has to stand here and give him oxygen.
Yes.
Their hand, and it's really... No. So you may be here an hour, somebody doing this.
Yes.
Then somebody maybe using these. Really heavy.
Yeah.
Through. That's why there's lots of blood.
Oh,
any
I see.
Idea what these might be? These are rib cutters.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, lovely.
So they're cutting through the ribs.
Yes.
To get the bullet out. I can tell you a story about a soldier if you like.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll tell you. There was this soldier walking past my chair the other day. Looks limping a bit like this. What's wrong with him? He might have trench foot. So he sat down, he took his boot off very slowly, then his sock. Now it's gone black. I said, oi mate, come in here, jump up onto my table. Gave him a bit of my morphine, which was in there. I took out my lovely big bone saw and I saw that foot off. Blood gore everywhere spurted out. So I got bandages, wrapped it up. And then he looked at me and he said, thank you. Why do you say thank you? Because he was still pain, but I gave him morphine. But he said thank you because the black on his foot could have travelled all the way up his leg. He could have lost all of his leg. He only lost his foot. Can you hop?
Get about, can you?
Hey, you've had a broken leg, haven't you? So you've hopped a lot.
So that's what happened. He came out, gave him crutches, and he hopped out my tent.
Thank you very much.
The storyline.
Right, what you're going to do is you're going to put that there up against your shoulder. You're going to
stop pressing the trigger.
Right, you're going to hold that there. What you're going to do, see that hat that's on there? You're going to get that lined up with it, and then that lined up with that and that. Okay, so aim that now, and when you're ready to take the shot, put that on the trigger.
You nearly got mowed down then.
There you go, you've just shot my pants off, you rat bag.
You literally have to do
that. Thank you so much. That's
no,
great
bullshit.
Oh, look,
at
Gabe with a good
idea. The Firebirds. Notice on the helmets, they started off like the aerobatics display team with mats.
Yes, oh yeah.
And bits of water, then worked their way up to the Lightning. A bit bone dome with the internal headphones and a mask and a leather flying jacket.
Yes.
They don't go for man-made fibres of the Russians, they all like leather and bits of wood.
Uh-huh.
And a British Vulcan bomber crewman.
Oh yes, yeah.
And again, a sub-weight sort of like... RAF flight suit, Russian bear, you know, type thing.
Yeah.
Again, Russian fighter pilot in a summer weight uniform.
Yeah.
High pressure, high altitude
wow.
suit.
Yes, let's get a view of that.
Yeah, Russian. RAF helicopter pilot with the immersion suit because you have to ditch in the sea.
Yeah.
And the Russian equivalent but for a fighter pilot rather than a helicopter pilot.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, I saw something like the Charlie G there.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
What, look at that.
We used to fire one ride round a year.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Used that as a practice strength for so far in a main munition.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree, yeah.
This is 303. I said 762. This is only 303 around. I said probably somewhere. Yeah, I was raff on like walking around stuff.
Well, it's a request you send telegram to my wife in South Africa to say I'm well.
Is that right? I can't imagine how they could absorb that quickly enough to understand what it was.
Well, this bit was just written by a guy who just walked past who used to read Morse.
And he actually...
And I said, we've just got a recording, we don't know what it says, can you translate for us? And he sat listening and just wrote this out.
Marvellous,
yeah. Yeah, it was unbelievable.
That's good. Wow, that is unbelievable. Well, I'm glad I looked in.
Thank you.
know, mate.
Is that what they call rummaging?
Indeed.
Have you found what you want yet?
I'm collecting a large number of patterns here.
Yeah.
I do a lot of vintage knitting.
Yeah, brilliant, brilliant. Wonderful opportunity, isn't it?
It is. And it keeps me out of mischief as well.
Yeah, I bet.
Now, they were trained to send messages
languages and interpret a command. As who's going to broadcast a message to you, and we'll see if you can see what she's saying. And the message she sent to you all was, hello!
Thank you. without you. They will carry me through to
milk, but no sugar. Yeah, please. Brilliant. Thanks ever so much. Thank you.
We'll have a drink before. Yeah. All right then. We'll see you in a bit.
Zina's round anyway.
Good.
Oh God.
Mine was
reasonable.
Is it? I thought mine was really good. Yours are probably a bit cold by now and then. Is your fork still surviving?
Yeah.
Oh, you did better than me. Yeah, cheers. That was a good place.
Well, not you, no. That's you.
That's me chattering there.
Blaming you. That's not good enough, is it?
Double dutch to me. I ain't got a computer.
Yeah.
No. Oh, you got two.
Oh, have you?
Yeah.
God, you got two.
I've got a bloody laptop.
Yeah. See, lovely, see?
There's only one of them.
Yeah, certainly got you on the one, haven't I? I got you on the one Plum Festival, haven't I, recently?
We're on the telly, Marion.
Anyway. Yeah.
Pardon? We're on the telly.
Are we?
Yeah.
YouTube.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll have to have a look at that.
Yeah, oh, you'll be in it.
You'll be on there now.
You'll be on there as well.
Yeah, you'll be on there tonight when you're on that stage.
We were going to have
you. Oh, let that one split.
On a hot day, yeah.
Get roasted.
You have to put the air conditioner on a hot day.
I should be roasted in the day.
Yeah, you definitely need the air conditioner.
Yeah, David, I've got to see what time you're going home.
I am lost. I know where I've been and I know where I'm going, so it's all right.
What are you saying? You ain't got your care of me, have you?
Yeah, unsupervised.
So it wasn't a fire? Well, I don't know. I think they may have been both. Yeah. I know the fire had a shout, so they went.
No, the fire went until night.
Yeah,
so they're
you sound like you were like me. I just missed out on national service.
I'm 77.
Yeah.
And that 77, I just missed it.
Yeah, we were expecting to go in, weren't we?
We're ready because all my other brothers had gone in. They'd all gone in. I've got nine brothers, so they're all going in. You're going in, and you're going next year. And I'm due to go in, so you're already packing your bags.
So our first couple is on the way, and I do believe that this one is an Albus Scorpion, and it's been joined by an Albus Imitator. We'll be telling you all about the brilliant vehicle in just a moment. But for now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, can you please all put your hands together for me and the Albus Fighting Vehicle Society and make them feel very, very welcome in our new, bigger and better arena here at Wartime in the Vale. Now then, boys and girls, as our drivers come round, make sure you give them the biggest smile and the biggest wave possibly can. The more you encourage these guys, the faster they will drive around our arena. They love demonstrations and they bring it demonstrations variously all over the world. A Scorpion, and we've also got a Scimitar in the arena. Scorpion is the one with the shorter little ditty gun on the front, and the Scimitar is the one with the longer gun. Now, the longer gun, actually, a smaller gun, that is a 30mm, and the other is a 76mm cannon. And just while the vehicles head around the arena, nice and gently for us, let me tell you a little bit of background with these vehicles. Built in the 1970s, originally they would have had a Jaguar straight six 4.2-litre petrol engine. Very nice engine found in many of Jaguar's brilliant road and race cars. Here we see it in a tracked vehicle, not a tank, CDRT.
Oh, I see yellow there.
They are very light on their feet, these vehicles. They weigh, in total, about 8 tons, which for the size of them isn't bad at all. However, as they do their practice turn here, as they're turning side by side, pay very close attention to tracks, and pay very close attention to ground underneath them. You'll see as they turn, they don't dig in or bite into the ground at all. And that's because the ground pressure of these vehicles is about 5 psi, so 5 pounds per square inch. Now, a grown man standing on the ground would put down a pressure of about 5.5 inches. So, that ground pressure would take it through the accident. So, what it means is you should be able to run over your foot without it hurting too much. But I'm not about to test that. So, we're doing a pirouette from the guys, and again, take a look, the track literally skating over the top of our arena grass here. Now then, watch them shake and jump as they fight their way through the gears. These vehicles have got 7 gears. We may have an explosion at this point, ladies and gents. Just be aware. There we are, ladies and gents. We haven't disappointed. That charge went off exactly as expected. Like I said, do expect very loud bangs. Well, very loud bangs. I want to expect the commentary point to be back. These have got 7 gears. 7 gears to go forward and 7 gears to go backwards. So now this is the vehicle driver forward,
I did see a nice tune there. George. I heard you.
Well, they packed us back.
Thank you.
Thank you. right now.
They love their dancing, don't they?
Yeah.
Real regulars, aren't they?
Yeah.
Thank you.
good, isn't it? Is that beautiful? Well done. Who's to the Long Johns?
Thank you.
Bye then.